Oh, it might be on the way. I think it's... Hey folks, it's BestInSlot. Welcome back to our horror park build in Jurassic World Evolution 2. If you missed the last video, what we did was we worked on the Indominus Rex paddock, including an earthquake. So the ground has split open. It's revealed part of the habitat, as you can see, but the Indominus, is kind of contained on the other side of the crevasse. All the buildings are breaking, everything's broken up, all the fences are smashed. It's got quite a nice aesthetic to it, actually. I think it would... What is going on here? The game is not handling the crevasse very well. But either way, I think it works really well. It looks pretty cool, actually. And obviously, I've moved the Indominus closer, as we did towards the end. I've messed around a little bit more with the pathing and the uppy-downiness, you know what I mean? Of course you know what I mean, using technical terms like that. How would you not know what I mean? The uppy-downiness, just to make the path feel like there's been commotion betwixt the path and the core. Basically, the earth has gone like that. Right, so today should be a pretty easy one. We're just going to work on the monorail section. Now, I ask you lovely folks for, what is this fence all about? Oh, because of that. Right, okay, I remember. I ask you folks for suggestions on this, about how to build, I'm going to have to get rid of this, unfortunately, and that. How to build the monorail section. Let's get rid of that path as well. Oh god, it's full of people, like little terrifying ants. We are going to need a new hatchery. Somewhere. Didn't think about this. we'll put it there for now, that's fine. There always has to be a hatchery somewhere, but I need to kind of like... Wait, is that even going to work? Is there a path there? Yeah? Yeah. So yeah, we're going to work on the monorail section. And I had lots of lovely suggestions from you folks at home, but the one I liked the most was making it Camp Cretaceous inspired. I thought that was a cool idea. Plus, it means I can be relatively chill today because it's not a very complex area. So we're going to do a Camp Cretaceous inspired monorail section. And that means TORO, basically. TORO was attacking you. If you think back to the end of season one, TORO was attacking the campers at the monorail, and that's just before the whole thing with Ben and the Dimorphodons and Pteranodon. Were there any Pteranodons in that scene? Maybe. I don't really remember. But either way, it was just before that scene with the pterosaurs. And that's what we're going to build. It's actually kind of perfect because... I say it's kind of perfect. Oh, this is kind of a pain in the ass. Okay, let me think. Because in that scene, the monorail... Okay. Work with me here. Monorail, right? Campers. If the campers move up to the monorail this way, don't know if this is helping at all. I don't have anything else to fight. So the campers move up, boop, 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 to get on the monorail here, and Toro's like fighting them on the monorail on the staircase. There is a, the only other thing you can really see in the area, there's like, I'm looking at it now, there's like concrete here, forest here, but here at the back, like before the staircase, is a lagoon. It's the Mosasaurus Lagoon. It's right here. So, lagoon. Monorail. Okay. You with me? Now, I was going to use this as part of it, but I don't think that's really going to work. Plus, that isn't a Mosasaurus. It will be. People keep having a go at me. It will be a Mosasaurus by the end. I promise. Promise? Promise is a strong word. It will be. I will. I'm going to do a clear of everything and then install the pertinent mods towards the end. Why do I have a path here? I have no idea. Right, so it is basically just some flat-ass concrete, a monorail, and a lagoon, and a Toro, and some invisible fence work and stuff like that. So it should be moderately relaxed, which is good, because I am exceptionally tired. I didn't sleep till about 5:30 this morning, and then woke up at 7:30, because my dad woke me up somehow. It was a weird night. I tried to sleep for so long. I was in bed at like 1 a.m. desperately trying to sleep. And you know those times where you can't sleep just because you're getting so many ideas and your brain's going a million miles an hour. It's like I've been writing lately. Or I've been planning a book, planning a novel, and not dinosaurs, I'm afraid. And I kind of put it on the back burner for a couple of months and kind of just let it in the back of my head. And then last night, it decided was the night that all the thinking about this book was going to appear all at one time. Right, so I think the only logical way to do this is to have the monorail over here and have the lagoon here and have them kind of... Because they go through the lagoon, don't they? They use like little dinghies to go through the lagoon. So obviously we can't do that. But we can... We have to get rid of that fish. But we can have like a little lagoon. The lagoon's not going to be full size. We're kind of working with quite limited space here, actually. But if I put that like... There... Trying to get the smack bang in the middle, because if it's in the middle, what we can do is I kind of want to hide this lagoon with forest. Now you will still see the fish, but the fish is temporary. He says, knowing the fish will not be temporary. Okay, so the plan is that you can kind of see this as its own section. You know, we don't need to. Eventually, you'll see a bit of the aviary, but you're not going to see the lagoon over there. I want it to feel separate from that other lagoon. Because I don't think there's a neat way of including that lagoon in this build. Before we move on to that bit, of course, what we need is a big chunky fence. Don't we all need a big chunky fence? Oh, no. Okay, well, let's go there. There, there. And then we need a gate. Cool. Just because we need our... we've got, you know, there's a system in place. Every time you enter a new level, and this is a new level, every episode is essentially a new level, then we need a torch, fire, Jurassic Park column, as they're known in the clubs. And then we also need a... I feel like every game I play, all I do is look down in this bottom left-hand corner, and therefore I hide myself down here, like, meh. Meh. Yeah. And then I have to make stupid noises about it to alleviate my slightly awkwardness. The awkwardness never goes away. Right. So, lagoon. If I was a lagoon, where would I be? I want the Jurassic World one specifically. I love that. These circles. Frontier. Big shout out. They're fantastic. They really are. So I'm going to have you... Can you do a triple? Yeah. Yeah. We could even, maybe we just make it chunky, yeah. Make it a little chunky. I'll change up that fence. That's the Indominus Rex paddock. It can't look like that, that's stupid. But if we go like that, for that fence builds. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. I like that they did this change, that the fences take a little bit of time to build, but it's also really annoying. It's definitely a good change in terms of gameplay, in terms of challenge, because it makes it a little bit more difficult to do the plan that we used to do. Not impossible, but it makes it harder to do what we used to do, where you would build fences for storms. You would just build the fence when it breaks, and it would build instantaneously, so there's no challenge involved. But I also kind of miss that. So I did do some research, as I'm prone to do. We need some attractions. There are lagoon viewing stands, kind of like facing their back towards where the monorail is. So they would be sitting... I hate when games do this. Just, what if I want to put down more than one, alright? Just let me put down more than one. You don't need to take it out of my hands every single time. It really bugs me. So we're going to put all those in. I'm not going to sneeze. Do I want the corner one? Yeah, go on then. Go on, live a little. Oh, no, you don't live over there, though. Don't know what the voice is, but oh, no. It's the Churchill dog, actually. Fellow blighty people will understand what the Churchill dog is. Everyone else will think that's nonsense. Right. So you're going to come straight down. So these obviously have to connect. This is actually a little bit... It's a little bit far. I'm going to bring the monorail forward. It has to be... There's not much gap between the monorail staircase and these things. So I'm going to bring it more down to, like, there. It feels silly, because I've just been complaining about the lack of room, but that's what it is. Yeah. How's everyone doing? This should be a chill episode, so I can kind of talk to you a little bit. I feel like I don't really do that on this channel. I kind of do that just on the other channel. I have another channel, by the way. Hint, hint. Wink, wink. It's in the comment section down below. But, right. So this kind of... It's kind of like a block of concrete there. And then this is all concrete. I think going like from here, I'm gonna bring that down, and then I think from that level there across is basically gonna be pure concrete. Sexy, sexy concrete. And then that probably to at least... to where that viewing thing is there. So that needs to come up. As long as the things are blocked, I'm relatively happy. Never fully happy. Of course I'm not. I'm a millennial. yeah, how's everyone doing? Everyone good? It's been a weird week. Sometimes you get like really excited about YouTube, and sometimes it's kind of a struggle, you know. And this has been a struggly week. I'm not gonna lie. I'm quite excited about this build, actually. I'm very excited about the horror park. I cannot wait to actually go through the horror park and complete it. I do want to address a criticism, however. The hoodie. People keep going on. Because I always wear the same hoodie. And people don't realize my genius. Okay, I'm going to explain my genius. Just so people are aware. Right. Everyone knows. Sometimes cliches are real. Right. And that there's a thing wherein... when you're dating someone. Especially... No, not especially anything, really. You're dating someone, they tend to steal your hoodie. Right? That's just... A tale as old as time itself, essentially. What I need, actually... Is big trees. Oh. People steal the hoodie, right? So whoever I next date will see all these videos of me in this hoodie and think, oh, that must be his favorite hoodie. That'll be the one I steal, because that's how it works, right? I know this is all cliche nonsense, but in my experience, this cliche is cliche for a reason, because it's very much true. And they'll think, oh, that's his favorite hoodie. I'll steal that one. What they don't know is that I hate this hoodie from the bottom of my heart. It's a demon hoodie. It's the worst thing I've ever had on my person. All of this is a lie, but I'm doing it for the joke. And then they'll steal it, and I'll be like, oh no, they took my favorite hoodie. But really, I'll be like, well, I guess I'll wear this one, and I'll wear a different one. I do have a different one. I've got a Discord one. And I'll wear the other one, and then I'll be like, oh, you got me. But really, I'm wearing my favorite hoodie. They just don't know. Yeah? Yeah? Someone tell me I'm not crazy. I think I'm a genius. Unless my mum thinks I'm smart. All right, leave me alone. In reality, it is my favorite hoodie, but that's not really not there. This is going to take a while. This is going to be a lot of path work today. Usually, I would skip it, but because this episode is so low key, because this episode is 99% path work, and by path work, I mean just filling in gaps like I'm a freaking 5-year-old. You kind of can't skip it, because the video will be about 2 seconds short. 2 seconds long. And 2 seconds long is not appropriate in any scenario. Well, we'll see. anyways. So, yeah, just going to keep sticking. This is literally all we have to do today. Stick down myriad path. Myriad. There's your word for the day. Myriad. Fantastic word. Is anyone still doing Wordle? I know, like, Wordle kind of died, right? Well, not died, but it's definitely... It had its moment in the cultural zeitgeist, and now it's kind of faded a little bit, right? But I got really into it. I came to it really late. I only started doing it a couple of weeks ago, like after it had already been bought out by the New York Times. I really like it. I do it every single day. My dad does it every day. He texts me his score when he's at work and stuff like that. I know, it's adorable. Yeah, super into it. Nice little, I don't know. Nice to use your brain every now and again. Even if you kind of... I feel like you use your brain, sure, you still test your vocabulary, but the words are always fairly basic, typically. Although we had Oxide the other day, and Oxide came out of bloody nowhere. Spoilers, I suppose. What am I doing with my life? No, let's not go there. I'm not even thinking about this. I'm just slap it down, you know? Stick it in, hope for the best. It's always worked out in the past. Except that time I nearly killed someone. I feel like I have to keep talking and I have to make it slightly interesting because gameplay-wise, not thrilling stuff. Although that looks pretty good. It's actually too far away still, but that's fine. And then the last bit of... Well, this really is going to be short. The last bit of path we need is like a blob underneath the monorail itself. Not all of the monorail. Maybe up to like there. And how do you make this symmetrical? You can't really. Let's do it to about... There? Why aren't you symmetrical? Why isn't everything in the world should be symmetrical? people, planets, dinosaurs. All those things could be symmetrical. And I'm trying to think desperately of something that is inherently unsymmetrical by design. Asymmetrical by design, I should say. And I cannot think of a single thing. What has to be asymmetrical? A banana. No, bananas can be symmetrical, just down the middle. It's hard for a camera to be symmetrical. Because you've got the grip on one side. You can have a grip on both sides, but it'd be unnecessarily long. And we wouldn't want that, would we? I'm really struggling. Art. Some art can be symmetrical, obviously, but, you know, I think if all art was symmetrical, that would be stupid. Right, okay, so, this monorail, I think, is going over here, yeah? Yeah. If I was a monorail, where would I be? I would be here. So the plan, we've got some space to play with, which we need, because we're going to be in the vehicle, and, so let's just go there, and we'll drag this along. So, you think you've made it to, that's what we're doing. I completely forgot about this monorail plan I had. Okay, this was clever, actually. When they got the monorail, do they go right or left? They go right, which isn't really going to work, unfortunately. We have to go left. Wait. No, they go both ways. So it's fine. I'm just trying to figure out where they'll go when they get on the monorail. Because what we want to do, we want to join these two together. Right, this might seem illogical, but just bear with me. I don't really have any grand plans for this. I quite like how the monorail looks when it goes through things. So I don't really mind just having it cavort along the entire place. Okay, so you get into the monorail, you think you're heading to freedom, but then you see Chapeau, Le Gap, and Le Track. We'll just break it up in lots of parts all over the place. Sorry. So you don't actually get your freedom, you get to here, and then you realize you have to get out. And then you have to go again. Because we're not exiting the park via monorail, we're exiting the park via helipad, remember? Now, as far as I can tell, there is no sense of there's no fencing or anything like that in this area. It is just concrete. It's actually very boring. It's just concrete and foliage. There is nothing else to speak of. There's nothing fancy there. There's nothing stopping your guests just wandering into the darkness and being torn limb from limb. So we want to try to contain Right. Next problem. How do people think if they don't have any facial hair? I don't know how I would do it. I suppose you just do your chin in general. Side note, if you have a beard, get beard oil. Seriously, it changed my life. It really did. It's really easy for your skin to get like super irritated under a beard. It can get quite painful, like tugging it like that or just doing anything with it. But beard oil and beard shampoo really changed my life. I don't want to say changed my life, but it was a positive effect. Alright, it was good. And it was good. As they say in the clubs, Shingo Shango. So I didn't actually enunciate what the problem was. So the problem is, Toro is obviously going to be contained within an invisible fence, and I want to contain him around the monorail, because that's where he would be in this scene. But if there's an invisible fence, the guests can't walk through it. Do you see the problem? How do I do both? I could either contain Toro in this whole area, which, speaking of which, I should, is there a fence there? No, what am I doing with my life? Did I delete that? Why would I do that? That's very silly. Stop being curvy. Thank you. I won't often say that to anything, but in this circumstance. Okay, we want to block that off. And this area is pretty cool. Oh, not that though. That's not cool beans at all. That's the worst kind of bean. Moderately warm beans. Not on my watch. All my beans will be cool. No, who are you? Okay, they're blocked. Oh, right, okay, yeah, right, okay. right, so we need another invisible fence because they can come way too far down. It's kind of cool, though, the little Cragnosaurus just going to wander along, but I'd like to contain it. I don't want this fence here because the guest is obviously going to walk into that like a numpty. Oh, what is going on? Cragton, please. Cragton, please. No, Cragton, please, no. Cragton, no. I don't even have a response facility anymore. I'm Cragtonsaurus. Can't be trusted. I wouldn't have realised this was a problem unless for the Cragton. So shout out to the Cragton for that. Right, where if I put that hatchery? There. This is slightly awkward, but we can just stick that there for now. Get rid of that at the end. Where are we? We're over here. Maybe they've gone back in? Oh, they have! Oh, glory! Right, okay, so we just need to delete that there, and that should be better. So you might see the Cragtons wander out, but they're never gonna like come right up to you. Wait, what? What? Did that? What? I kind of like the broken fence. Where did they go? It must have, when I put in the new fence, it must have repaired that fence for some reason. That's strange. So this is really the last big problem I have, is how do I get Toro in? What I'm considering is just putting the fence here. And Toro can run around the whole area. I think that's what we'll have to do. I don't really see a better idea than that. So let's go from here. I'll contain into the concrete as best I can. Plus that way it doesn't kill the trees. Between, like that. Look at that. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay, is he contained there? Can he walk through the mono? Can he walk through this? I'm going to put the fence just also going through that just in case. I don't think he can walk through the lagoon. I'm just going to put a fence around the lagoon. You're never going to see it anyway, right? It's invisible. So we'll put a fence around the lagoon just in case. And that should be fine. Yeah. Yeah, okay, cool. I just feel like it needs something else. There isn't anything there in the scene, but, you know, I'm not a slave to the scene. I am the master of the scene. Yeah. Oh, I need a bloody... Okay, I don't know if this works, but we're going to find out. I think it does, so I'm going to put that there. Just take that there. Thank God for free build sometimes. This would be tricky stuff without free build, I tell you. I need a Mosasaurus. Obviously, Mosasaurus right now is a giant fish, but I need a Mosasaurus in this lagoon, obviously. Also, I want to put some stuff in for the Mosasaurus. Let's, there'd probably be a lagoon hatchery somewhere. Sure. And I had a look on the site, or I watched the Netflix thing, and there's tons of rocks over at one side. There's like an almost like rocky outcrop, nature-y shebang going on. Which I would like to try to replicate a little bit. It's going to be weird. I'm using Tiger Rock. Oh, I don't know. I've already committed now. What I want is like a bit of land actually sticking out into here, but that's not going to happen. So we're just going to go a little bit crazy with the rock. It'll do. It didn't have to be anything fancy. Right, I mean, this should work in theory. Mosasaurus. Mosasaurus. We need default, which is Rana, and no pattern, I believe. Is it Rana? Maybe it's not Rana. Oh, Rana's a pattern. Wait, so what's the default? Blue? I'm worried that the blue is going to be too blue, but the grey is going to be too grey. I need to make them, breed them, and then use the baby. It's a strange sentence. Blah, 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 blah. Let's go blue. And we'll go... I don't think there's a pattern, so we're going to get rid of the pattern. I don't really know what I'm doing there, but we'll give it a go. And then we should just... put it. I mean, it looks like a disaster, but we should, in theory, be able to transport this straight over to our hatchery over here, to our lagoon. I think I'm basically done, honestly. Oh, we need Toro. Where's Toro? Whoopsie daisy. Sorry, buddy. Can we have like an aggressive one? Yeah, that's more like it. So this will be one of the first times where you literally just... You walk into a big, wide open area. There's a freaking dinosaur. Deal with it. Your challenge is to get onto the monorail. Now, what I'm curious about is, can you get onto the monorail, actually? I hope you can. Help? No path to arrival point. So is that not working? Because there's no path to arrival. Okay. Okay, that's fine. Sorry, we can figure anything out, folks. We can figure anything out. Okay, I'm gonna put a monorail here. Right there. I'm gonna delete. And we're gonna connect. And then we'll block. We'll just block that off from the guests entirely, and then it'll be fine. Alright. Yeah. Yeah. There we go. I mean, that makes sense anyway. There would be a monorail down here, so. It's fine. Science. I'm thinking I might mess this around a little bit. Maybe some lights. Maybe some flags. Maybe a spinosaurus. No. You know, some benches in the area. Something to liven it up, you know. you know, a little fountain. It's pretty, pretty. Pretty, pretty. Pretty, pretty. Big light. There for reasons of science. Don't argue with me. Yeah, there would be stuff going on. You know, this is a park more in development than the Camp Cretaceous one was, right? Which was kind of officially opened, obviously, because it's Jurassic World, essentially. So there'd be some stuff lying around. You know, they were working on some stuff. Not too much, but just little dilly-dally things here and there. I don't know why dilly-dally is relevant in every single scenario for me, but it is. It is. Dilly-dally. Some crates. Not too... I do like it being relatively open, but I think it just needs a little something. But, yeah, you walk through, you go around. Hopefully that now works. I mean, guests will start taking... No, they won't. Not yet, they won't. Okay. Now they will. But all we're going to do, invisible wall, block it off. Apparently from over here for some reason. Let me just... There we go. There we go. The guests don't need to come over here, right? But it now works in theory. Nice, you can get on and then, is that the right way? Well, it took me over here. Yay, sweet. Okay, so it took me to the next stop, which is exactly what we want in terms of how this is going to function as a video game. Awesome. Yeah, that's perfect. That's great. Oh, I'm super chuffed. Come on, you big fish. This is going to look bizarre. Wait for it. Wait for it. Any second now. Can be a big fish too. Oi. Oh god. And the madness. Up you pop. Come on, buddy. What's going on? It's like it's too strong. We've got this really stretchy rope. He's just trying to pull it desperately. I think it's going to teleport over here in a second. Oh, it might be on the way. I think it's... What the hell is going on? it still there? Wait, is it there? Okay, it is still there. Okay, I'll uninstall the mod. That was mad. Right, we are basically done, folks. It's a little bit on the dull side, I admit, but it is realistic. And I think it being nice and wide open like this is actually quite good anyway. Let me explain why. Because all the areas so far, you know, have been very tight corridors and really contained, and you're always juking and jiving between boxes and stuff like this. This time you come through here, you're walking along, preferably Toro at the time is alive. Toro! Anyways, preferably Toro's like over there somewhere. Yeah, he's there. So, I mean, that's great, right? Okay, yeah, it's a bit wide open and a bit blah, but you can see the Carnotaurus and you can see the monorail and you're like, it's like a standoff a little bit. And you're like, doo 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 doo, and Toro's running for you. He's running for you, and you doo 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 doo, and you hop into the monorail, and you hop out the monorail, and you, oh, that didn't work. Ah, let me back in. Okay, and you hop on the monorail, and it takes you to the next bit. Awesome. And if you mess up, Toro's right there in front of your face. So I don't think I want to add anything else. This matches the film, matches the series. I think adding more stuff might ruin it a little bit. Maybe some more lights and stuff, or little things that could maybe fit with the theme. Maybe some flags and stuff like that, I think would be okay. I will think about that. I quite like it as it is. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. You know, would you do anything to brighten this area up, or do you think it's a good idea to kind of keep it as it is right now? But I actually really like how this looks. Hello, buddy. I think it's a pretty cool little area. And it's the finish of this whole section. Look at the size of this park. Look at this. Whoa, madness. Madness. No, not sneezing now. I survived so long. So, next video. There's going to be something going on when you land. I don't know what. You're gonna get in the vehicle. We're going to do the aviary tour. You're going to drive through the aviary. Then you're going to have to get out of the car. Get into another car. And then do like a safari zone. Or we do safari zone first. No, I want you to walk in the aviary because I think that's a cool idea. Safari zone, the Spinosaurus. And then finish off with the T-Rex and the final jump towards the exit. So, 3 episodes left in theory. But if you have any other suggestions or ideas, feel free to let me know in the comments section down below. I will see you lovely folks very, very soon. Hope you've enjoyed. Have a lovely weekend. Cheers. Much love. Look how much love. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.